A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 21st November, on the front page you have government to sell off its stake in BPCL for other PSUs. So this is what Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman has said, that Union Cabinet has approved the government's proposal to sell its entire 53.29% stake in BPCL, Bharat Petroleum Corporation Limited, and it is BPCL, which itself has 61.65% share in Numaligarh Refinery Limited. This will also be transferred to a public sector company operating in the oil and gas space. This has been announced. And this another decision of Union Cabinet is that telecom companies have now been given 2-year moratorium on pending spectrum payment. So this will help telcos avoid an immediate outflow of 42,000 crores to the government. Then this is center plans NRC exercise all over the country. So this is what Home Minister Amit Shah has announced. He said that there will be no bias and the survey will be repeated in Assam too. So this is a controversial announcement now being made. So you can see, he said the Home Minister, he spoke about this NRC all across the country earlier too. And now he has announced in the parliament. Then this is draw up a special law to run Sabarimala, says Supreme Court. So Supreme Court has directed Kerala government to draft a law exclusively covering administration of Sabarimala Sri Ayyappa Swami temple by January, so by third week of January. So the bench has expressed dissatisfaction when state chose to produce a draft bill, that is Travancore Cochin Religious Institutions Amendment Bill of 2019, containing certain proposed amendments to the Travancore Cochin Religious Institutions Act of 1950. So bench said have a separate act for the Sabarimala temple. Then this is Kashmir detentions made in national interest, says centre. So there have been 5,161 preventive arrests made in Kashmir Valley since August 4. And Home Minister Amit Shah said in Rajya Sabha that normalcy has been restored in Jammu and Kashmir and not a single person has been killed in police firing since August 5, when the Article 370 of the Constitution was revoked. On page 4 you have install AQI monitoring stations across India, NGT. So National Green Tribunal has directed state pollution control boards across the country to install assessed air quality monitoring stations within 1 year and submit quarterly progress reports to the Central Pollution Control Board. So here you can see, it noted that according to assessments carried out, 800 continuous ambient air quality monitoring stations and 1,250 manual stations are required in addition to the already existing ones in the country. On the editorial page, the first editorial is senseless. So this is regarding the decision which we saw on the front page of a nationwide extension of NRC. So this is called by the editorial as bizarre. And the repeat of it in Assam, it is said, is illogical because it has just been concluded in Assam. So why should it be repeated there? And the second editorial is an opening. So this is regarding the transport workers' strike in Telangana. So they have been agitating for 47 days now. And they actually had concerns because Telangana State Road Transport Corporation is a loss-making entity and they wanted it to become complete subsidiary of the government, so that their jobs are secured, so that it's not affected because government would take care of it. So now transport workers show willingness to end strike and now the ball is in government's court. So Telangana state government had been very stringent on them. It had actually removed everyone from services too. So such views were taken by the government. So we have to wait and watch how the government responds now. The lead article, the new tenor in Maharashtra's politics. So this is about how Shiv Sena, which insisted on 50-50 formula with the BJP, its pre-poll alliance was with BJP, and now they are struggling to form government because with the BJP saying it is not able to form the government, Shiv Sena tried with NCP and Congress, but it has not been successful, and President's rule has now been imposed in Maharashtra. So it is said Shiv Sena's brinkmanship is the outcome of its struggle for survival in a BJP dominated polity. So BJP is gaining dominance, so Shiv Sena wanted to assert itself. And second article is the myths around free trade agreements. So it is said free trade agreements, they can ensure market access, but it is only the right quality products which get market access at competitive prices. If you don't have good quality products and at competitive prices, then free trade agreements would not be beneficial for us. So this is important. On OPED page you have in variance with the official growth story. So it says surveys, including the recently leaked one on consumer expenditure, point to economy's dire state. So how various of data which is coming forth is showing that the situation in the economy is in crisis. So how fast has India grown lately, and what are the yardsticks on which country's performance has been manufactured? So these are the contentious questions, but you can see that NDA government does not give data, and data which have been which have been showing that growth has gone low, or any data which is not favorable to it, it has tried to suppress it. In early 2015, Central Statistics Office released a new series of national accounts with base year 2011-12, replacing the earlier system with 2004-05 as the base year. So this is actually a routine exercise for any statistical office. But the annual GDP growth rates were distinctly higher in the new series compared to the old series. So the growth rate for 2013-14 went up sharply from 4.8% in the old series to 6.2% in the new series. So these are how data was showing favor to the government. And this is JNU truly national. So this is regarding JNU, where protests are going on presently regarding fee hike and other such decisions, dress code on students. So the article says that the institution JNU is a microcosm of India, where the poorest and the brightest arrive to chase their ambitions. So JNU truly represents the nation. And this is an inexplicable withdrawal. So this is regarding SPG cover being withdrawn from the Gandhis. So this article says that government has ignored risks to Gandhi's lives while withdrawing SPG cover. On page 12 you have scrap updated NRC, Assam government urges center. So now Assam government is also asking the central government to scrap the NRC. So NRC exercise in Assam was a Supreme Court monitored exercise, and the final NRC was published on 31st August 2019. And since the data has not been favorable, because many Muslims have been included into the NRC and many tribals have been excluded, so Assam government wants to show that it is also against the NRC of Assam, and it has asked the center to scrap the updated NRC. Such a huge exercise which was conducted, now demand is to scrap it. Also front page we saw central government announced that NRC would be nationwide and also again for Assam. Even today's editorial talks about this. This is nod for industrial relations code bill. So Union Cabinet has approved the industrial relations code bill 2019, which aims to bring together and simplify provisions of three laws covering trade unions, industrial employments and disputes. So these three laws as such would be simplified through this industrial relations code bill. Then this is no Aadhaar social media link. So government has informed the Lok Sabha that it has not received any proposal on the issue. So there is no proposal for Aadhaar social media linking. On page 13 you have US ready to sell naval guns for $1 billion. So Trump administration has notified Congress, that is the US Parliament, about its plan to sell the weapons. So here you can see it is determined to sell $1 billion worth of naval guns to India for use against warships, anti-aircraft and shore bombardments. So this is proposed sale, foreign military sale of up to 13 MK-45 5-inch 62 caliber naval guns and related equipment. On international page you have US Senate passes Hong Kong rights bill. So this bill passed by US Senate, the upper house of US, mandates action against Chinese officials who commit rights abuses. And China has vowed countermeasures now. And this is 106 dead in Iran protests. So this is what Amnesty International has said, that government crackdown has killed at least 106 people across Iran. And this is Suu Kyi to lead Myanmar's defense against ICJ case. So International Court of Justice is having this case of atrocities against Rohingya Muslims in Myanmar. So the accusation on Myanmar is of genocide against Rohingyas. So Myanmar civilian leader and Nobel Peace Prize winner Aung San Suu Kyi will head a delegation to UN's top court ICJ to defend a case accusing Buddhist country of Myanmar of genocide against Rohingya Muslims. So this has been announced by the government. So even Aung San Suu Kyi has been criticized and as such for not raising her voice against atrocities against Rohingya Muslims. Then on page 15, business page, you have Reserve Bank supersedes DHFL board. So Reserve Bank, which is the regulatory body in banking sector, will initiate insolvency proceedings against DHFL, Dewan Housing Finance Corporation Limited. So it's a mortgage financer, DHFL. So the board has been superseded by RBI, and now insolvency proceedings will be initiated. Then this is listed firms to disclose defaults within 31 days. So disclosures are essential, and it is said, this SEBI chief says that these disclosures will help remove ambiguity. So when firms are listed on the stock exchange, they'll have to disclose defaults within 31 days. And this is continuation of the front page news. No plan to waive dues for telcos post Supreme Court ruling on AGR. So Telecom Minister Mr. Prasad says that telecom firm owe government 1.47 lakh crores in license fees, and spectrum usage charges. So this will not be waived off, but yes, 2-year moratorium, as we saw on the front page, has been given for telecom companies to pay to the government, but they'll have to pay the full amount. So this, and then on the last page you have ISRO uses satellite data to gauge North Korea's 2017 nuclear test impact. So scientists at ISRO have used a novel mathematical technique and analyzed satellite images to estimate the strength of North Korea's underground nuclear test of September 2017. So these tests are considered to be the most powerful thermonuclear devices being tested. So ISRO has also used satellite data to understand the impact. And it says it is equal to 17 times that of Hiroshima explosion. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aashar.com. Thank you.